Question what?
10.
Question what?
10.
10! Ah, we're out of fingers!
We are, we that's it now.
Good lord.
Right. Let's stop doing the podcast right now.
Well, no, well, what else could we possibly... We need to get a third person in. We need to have...
Yeah. To be fair, there are two of us. We can go up to 20. We should be all right.
Yeah, we've got, yeah. Right, what's happening, Dave? Question 10.
Right, question 10?
Question 10, that's 20. You just No, one hand. Question
10! This is quite a tame question for us.
Well, it is.
There's no blancmange hats.
There's
in
no
the
blancmange. I don't think there's any violence. There's nothing. There's no sex acts involved.
There's
well, it depends upon what. Well, that depends.
Who knows? Rob, what's your fourth favourite greeting?
A reach around.
Can't go back.
Imagine that. The first thing you do when you meet someone is not only crack one up, but you've slipped one up as well. Imagine that. That's a heck of a first impression, isn't it?
I'll be honest, it's the only reason I come round to your place.
No, the thing is, you said that about coming here and us answering the question.
But this isn't your flat, this is Moonbase Alpha.
Moonbase Alpha, coming to Moonbase Alpha, which I am currently the custodian of. Right, the thing is... Depressurisation. The thing is, right.
What I wouldn't give now to have a little Lego model of Richard Keel.
Or just some red flashing lights and a bit of a siren. Yeah. No, thing is, when you... I was thinking about a different greeting. Stop looking at my thing.
I'm not looking at you.
Right. Thing is, I was thinking about this. You arrived and it occurred to me that I'd chosen my number one, and the thing is, you arrived and I hugged you.
Yeah, I've got a hug on my...
I know, but I am a hug. I'm a hugger. I'm not like super tactile, but I'm a hugger. I think it's quite a nice form of greeting. And it occurred to me that the thing that I picked as my number one as the best kind of greeting was possibly not the best kind of greeting, and I'll tell you why. Because if I am not going to greet you, my co-podcaster, my good friend Dave Pitt, with the best greeting, then something's alright.
So the hug's not your best greeting?
No, it is. It's the best greeting.
Oh, it's the best.
It's the hey!
Yeah.
So I've done that.
I love hugs.
They're great.
I'm a very huggy person.
They're great.
As long as you haven't got scabies.
Yeah, okay.
Then that goes down.
Unless, if the person has scabies and you are itchy. Because if you're feeling
scabies and
they're itchy
and you want to be itchy.
No, but if you're already itchy and someone's covered in the scabies, and that can... It's like finding a nice... It's like Baloo finding a particularly nice tree, isn't it?
Can I just say, we're recording on a different camera, it's flashing red there, what's that mean?
That means, like with most video cameras, I am in the process of recording a thing.
That's okay then.
You know what it is? That camera, the Moonbase camera, heard my request for flashing red lights.
and started.
And has gone for, hey, you know what? If we turn the illumination down. Hang on. Illumination down.
It's not worked, has it?
I need to speak to the... I need to do some coding. But right, if we could get the lights to go down somehow, and then we got really close to the camera, that flashing red light would illuminate us in a really spooky way. Or not spooky, but dramatic. Well,
thanks for that.
Thanks for that! That's a cool story, bro, you bastard!
On the thing of hugs.
Yes.
Right? My mate Beamsy... does the best hugs.
Can I ask a question?
I mean, I do amazing hugs.
Can I ask a question about Beamsy?
Beamsy, yeah.
Is he a fatty?
He's a big man. I wouldn't say he's fat, but he's a big man.
Because, and it's not, like, all I'm saying is, you need some cushion.
You need some heft.
Yeah, yeah.
And this is the thing, you see, because when Beamsy hugs you, you need to be kind of broad on shoulders, full of breath.
Because otherwise...
Because, like... If he did you, he would snap you like uncooked spaghetti.
Right.
You just like a twiglet.
Well, I'm also but mostly boneless. So I'd be like, I'm all like, not in my hands, obviously. My hands are like a nice sort of bone paint, bone dust at the moment.
The one thing I've always said about me and Beamsy is that one day we're going to get a flat together for some reason. And we'll probably just die of starvation, just hugging each other. In a completely non-sexual way. Because his hugs are amazing.
Almost,
and he
almost
thinks my hugs are amazing. And we could just stand there for eternity, hugging.
Hugging.
And then dying. But in a non-sexy way. If we did do anything in a sexy way, the website that was hosting that bear porn would see a massive increase. We'd be popular.
I'm just saying, let it go. You don't need
this week's number one.
It doesn't need a two heterosexual men hugging.
If we got it on together.
No, cool.
Right. Yeah, the bear porn community would enjoy that one. I think there's already been requests. Actually.
Really? You've got a fan base.
Oh yeah.
you know the negative of hugs, which it occurs to me, is that if you're in a group of people there, you know everybody apart from one person,
mm-hmm.
You then feel an obligation to sort of hug that person as well.
Mm-hmm.
You've hugged all the others, and it's kind of like, oh hey. So it's either I'm making it obvious that I'm not going to hug you, which makes it a bit weird. Or I hug you and I don't know you. That's weird. I've had to do that a few times.
Yeah, hugging strangers is a weird thing, isn't it?
I'm standing by that. It is one of the best greetings ever.
It is.
It's warmth. It shows warmth. You can actually do, and I particularly enjoy this one, even though I think it is argued that it's kind of a It's kind of a mid-step between for men who aren't comfortable entirely around men,
mm-hmm.
where they're going for the handshake and they pull the other one in But do you know what? I think it still shows an element of sort of familiarity and warmth,
and I think that's
nice. So I'm not even going to lose any points for that. That's a hybrid, that's a fusion greeting.
So this thing of strangers, for instance, and the hugs may be a bit too much.
Yeah.
Where do you put the handshake, my good man?
Where do I put?
I like a good handshake.
The handshake's very high. The handshake's my number four.
Sir.
So thanks for that. no, the handshake, I think it's classic. It's classic, and I'll be right back. Right, we won't have to explain why there was an edit there, because...
I couldn't believe you just went, wait there, got up, stop the camera. That could have done I don't know what to the memory card.
What, I mean the pause button that's actually installed on the actual device has a pause, and it goes, what? No, I stopped it because the tea was a done steeping, so there we go.
Rest handshakes. Assured, next time I come here, mate, you're getting a handshake.
Oh, is that right? Well, we'll see. Now, what we'll end up doing is that bro thing, because you'll go in for the handshake, and I'll go in for the hug, and we'll end up somewhere in between. Mm. Actually, do you know one of the reasons why the handshake is
actually
is,
that's good tea. You're well, back up to a hug.
One of the reasons why a handshake is lower than, I know it's classic, original. It's the sort of thing that so many people do, and you think, well, why isn't it higher up? But I'll tell you why it's not higher up. There is a balance of power. There's a rest that you can. It's not an even keel. You can't necessarily go into a handshake without exerting dominance, and I think that's bullshit.
Well, you see, there's this whole thing, isn't there, about how Donald Trump shakes someone's hand. He shakes his hand and then he puts his hand over theirs,
mm.
and then there's the tap on the shoulder. It's supposed to be all this kind of alpha male bullshit.
Mm.
I don't get it myself. I just Donald Trump, I'd hug him.
Let's see where it goes from there.
Yeah, and you know when they just kind of go on a bit too long, the hugs.
Yeah, and you can feel your erection. That's some classic Dave Pitt material there. Yeah. No, I reckon what you do is you go in and you you shake the hand.
Mm-hmm.
You shake the hand, and then he goes in to go to do the dominant thing, and you shake his other hand, and you end up doing the whole design. That's what you do. And also that prevents...
World leaders, I hope you're watching.
And that also prevents... Because, like, you know the whole thing with shaking hands? It's originally proving I do not have a gun, a knife. And then what you do is you end up getting stabbed in the back by the knife that was in their other hand. So if you cross hands and do Auld Lang Syne, you're all right. Definitely no knives. Classic Rob Kemp material. What is this, the hits? That was never a hit, Rob. He did it like twice at the Hollybush and it did not go well.
To be fair, though, they don't like... Look at them, there's just nudity.
Well, trying to get the numbers up. Trying to get the numbers up.
They never liked you at the Hollybush.
No, they didn't.
Okay, right. I had a text the other day, which I thought was quite a nice greeting.
Okay.
It was an invitation.
I don't think going into a room and seeing someone that you know and then texting them is a good greeting.
No. This was just a way of greeting and starting the conversation. It was an invitation to watch a film on YouTube before it was officially released. So it was like an unlisted... And we all like walking through a door marked private, don't we?
Oh, we do.
You know what I mean? And
a velvet robe.
And the text message said, "Hey up, fuck nugget. Do you want to see this film? Twat out." I like "Hey up, fuck nugget." In fact, I think I used "fuck nugget" earlier when you ran off to use "mate the tea."
I think the swearing spectrum. Words have this sort of that in the middle. They don't really have. There's not a lot of placement for them in the middle. But there's extreme unpleasantness to someone. People that you hate and you want to send them bad vibes, and then the same words up the other end show a level of extreme
affection.
And closeness. It's good in the same talking about velvet ropes, and that's a Simpsons reference, and you're saying about specific verbal greetings. Ahoy hoy.
Ahoy hoy.
which has obviously Simpsons reference, because that's Mr. Burns' thing, and it also has the historical context of being the originally intended telephone answering greeting.
Ahoy hoy.
But unfortunately, as fun as that is, there's also something a bit sort of wanky and hipsterish. As if you, I mean, if you greet someone with ahoy hoy, you probably arrived on a Sinclair C5. And you're a bit of a twat.
And you've got very tight trousers on.
You've got very tight trousers
and a beard and short hair.
Quite possibly. quite possibly. Going back to our mate, the Donald Trump. Way down the list of greetings is grabbing someone by the pussy.
It is, isn't it?
It is. That is not the way to greet anyone in polite or impolite company.
I don't even greet my wife like that.
Well, exactly.
Anyone's got a right to grab at any pussy, it's mine on hers.
Well, this is it. It's not.
Is it still there? That's totally wrong what I've just said.
If anyone has the right ownership,
I don't
she
have
is
the
mine.
Right at all.
You don't.
No one has the right. That's my wife.
Exactly. So, unless you've been expressly invited,
I was
going to
go somewhere else with that, and then I thought, no, I'm not going anywhere else. I'm not gonna live up to this character that some people think that I'm playing. No,
it's all real. All of the misogyny is real. No,
unless you've had a specific invitation.
Yes, the rider, as it were. If you've had something arrive that says, upon arrival. The secret password is a couple of honks on the pussy.
If I say to you, ahoy hoy,
you have to honk.
You can grab away.
You can grab away at my pussy and or penis.
It's like when you've not long been going with a woman and you're never sure whether it's the right time to broach sex, but then you walk up into the bedroom and there's a condom on the pillow and you think, obviously wrapped up, not a used condom.
A used condom, the window's open and the curtains are flapping. It's like somebody just leapt out.
It's all right, dear, it was just a sign to say we can.
It was the plumber. It was...
a high up one from me.
Right.
And it hasn't happened very often, but it has happened. a knowing nod from someone who is the centre of attention.
Oh, I like that one.
Yeah?
I hadn't
thought
of that one.
So you walk into a room or you're there and stuff's been going on and everyone's talked to them and hang out with them and are pestering them. And in the middle of that group, this person looks over at you and just goes...
Well, they're even the thumb, I think.
Just like you say,
the knowing... Hey. That's the greeting version of...
The
little two-finger salute, isn't it?
It's great.
Not the two-finger salute.
It's a good one.
There's a lot of
love in that.
Do you know what? I think that is as close as you can get to tugging a forelock without tugging a forelock, or tipping your hat without wearing a hat. It's that one, isn't it? It's essentially that. Which might actually push tugging a forelock up my list. I've got some. The hongi is quite low down. I'm sure the Maori greeting, the hongi, if I'm even saying that right, I don't know if I am.
Oh, when they do the...
No, that's the hacker. No, the hongi. I'm sure it's lovely there, and I'm sure everyone goes around doing this. But what you do is you press your foreheads and noses together. I don't know enough people that I'd do that. Come here. Let's do that now.
That.
There we go.
That is a greeting.
That's a greeting, a Maori greeting. Now, on the one hand, I suppose you've kind of, sort of, you've dropped your guard there, haven't you? I don't feel violated, if I'm honest. Do you?
No, I'm trying to work out how I do feel.
Well, you saw. Well, they do say the eyes are the window to the soul. So I mean, you have just got. You just looked deep into my soul and saw the blackness, emptiness that resides there.
To be fair, that's more about my eyesight than it is about your soul. So.
Or the fact that it's a reflective surface, and you saw your own soul. Oh dear God. There's also the sampei. A Cambodian greeting, but which unfortunately, see, that's a sort of a pray. It's like sort of a kneel, pray. No, a bow. What is it? It's a sort of a pray bow. It's that sort of thing. You meet someone, you do the hand movement and you bow.
I've never done that.
There's also a Thai greeting called a way, which is also a pray bow. And I'm not sure if there's a difference of order or whether there's any kind of small discrepancy. But the problem with that is, it's like I don't know which one. Whether you get offended if someone goes, I saw that bitch, I gave her a sampei and she just fucking waved at me.
Yeah.
What a knob.
Yeah.
Who do you think I am?
This is not a formal invitation, why are you bowing before...
Yeah, I wish I'd have hongied her. Hard. drop the hong... Actually, is the head... Right, now, I've put a headbutt here. Right. Because it does show, I don't know how many people that would agree with a headbutt. But... It shows what's involved. It shows that you're there, physical contact.
A headbutt.
It shows its presence. It shows a certain amount of gusto and energy, and that you're getting involved. I mean, it's unsustainable.
Yeah.
For two reasons: one, your own forehead, and two, the amount of people willing to meet you anywhere.
And also the fact that if you both did it at the same time,
yeah,
it would be a very short meeting.
It would.
Because you'd both be on the floor with concussion.
Lying backwards. So when you're scheduling your meetings, the agenda always includes the 20-minute post-greeting recuperation. It's not exactly blank, but it's the lying around phase.
You know, the next AGM, shall we just save time and hold it in A&E?
Or shall we do handshakes? Hugs? Ah, Dave's not a hugger. Okay, headbutts it is.
You know that thing, this happens to me a lot, when people come up to you and say, you're right, and what they mean is, hello.
I mean, it was definitely around here.
They don't mean, are you all right?
No, they don't want to know. They do not want to know. Do not tell them.
So when you say, no.
And then elaborate
in some quite graphic detail onto the current predicaments that are going on in your mental health. They got all upset.
They don't want to know.
They don't want to know.
You asked, mate.
Yeah, exactly. You're right. He's a very much a Midland thing as well, isn't he?
Yeah, I definitely. People
saying you're all right, not going up to strangers and revealing your mental health.
Although having said that, you were right, and I mean, you said thing is, it is and it isn't a Midlands thing because I know purely because of hearing it in my mind that, all right, that's a great thing.
Oh yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah.
I don't know where. Because that was clearly an accent of indeterminate origin. So, but apparently there is a place somewhere in the southern hemisphere.
Loads of people in Dorset are going.
Why I order?
What's your fourth?
I've already told you. But I've got loads. I tell you what. See what's really high up? The Top Gun. Where you walk up to someone in your flight suit. And all of your homoeroticism.
Yeah.
And you clap hands together in a high five, but you carry on.
Oh, and then you do
the other way. Now, it's not entirely me at the top for one reason, and that's
you look
because,
like a dick.
No. That's you look awesome. No,
in your flight suit.
You can't. You're doing that, and you're doing that, and you're carrying on walking. So any meeting is brief. So it's essentially a greeting leaving. So it's not that high. However. You know what we were saying about, you know, handshakes and showing dominance and like how there can be weight, you can squeeze extra hard and all that sort of stuff. With the Top Gun, as I am choosing to call it, there is an element of teamwork.
Yes.
Because you're either high-fiving or you're, and if you miss, you've got to work together. Teamwork. And furthermore, whilst I say, this one is higher than the Fresh Prince.
Right, whoa, okay. Oh, right.
Because, and I'll tell you why, because the Fresh Prince greeting offers, unless you are Jazzy Jeff and or the Fresh Prince, there is no indication that is what you're about to do. It's a high five, and you might carry on to try and do a Top Gun. However, if you're going to do the Top Gun, you go, as you're advancing, when you're about 2 feet away from the person, maybe a little bit more, you go, I feel the need. And then they know straight away that you're bidding for there in the greeting auction of life is the Top Gun. You go, I feel the need for speed. And away you go. Of course, like I say, you don't hang around.
But what if you go in and you go, I feel the need for Uncle Phil's money, and it just kind of, you're just throwing them there.
I feel the need to avoid playground violence. Via the medium of moving cross country on a plane that they never mentioned.
How bad was that fight?
It must have been pretty bad. I mean, yeah, I mean, I've been in fights. Not many. I'm a lover, not a fighter. I'm not a fighter. No, but you know, to get sent cross country, that's a serious fight right there. Have you got any more apart from your fourth?
Only to say, I am really annoyed. Do you remember a few years back with the Budweiser advert? People who would greet you like that for the 4 years after that advert.
The thing is, as well, see, on the one hand, I agree, it's knobby and crappy. And also, not only was it just, I mean, doing something from an advert, referencing The Simpsons, apparently, not so bad. Let's say you've had a stroke.
Right, yes, okay.
You've had a stroke, so your speech centre, you haven't managed to get it back into action yet. So,
rah, rah, is the best you can manage.
The flexibility of what's up and da da, well, they took her to it! You know, that whole thing.
Where the hell are you going with this? Go on.
Just saying, not having to worry about the speech centres is very inclusive.
Okay, and your point is?
So, WhatsApp is not quite as wanky as I think it is.
Okay.
It's a bit wanky.
This is what I like about you. You will dig really deep into anything to find something positive.
It's what I do. You're the deeply political, informed person who lives in the actual world, and I am the idealist who's got a big shit-eating grin slapped all over my face, regardless of the walls crumbling down around him, inside his head. One day I'm going to snap.
You will.
No one's got this much positivity.
No.
This won't be enough.
One day you'll snap and I don't know, you'll go on some sort of killing spree. But it'll be the nicest killing spree ever.
Yeah, it will.
You're probably stabbing age victims.
How would you like to die?
What's the fourth way of Rob going on a killing spree?
I think kissing cheeks is a bit too close. That's closer than a hongi. Imagine if we'd have been in full on hongi and I'd have gone. That's the only way that you could have taken. Like, that's the only way that hongi is straight away worse. Straight away worse than kissing her cheeks. So we're there. Although, I now regret that I didn't do it. I'm so disappointed. Although, do you know what? Whenever somebody claps their hand over my mouth, like, to stop me speaking, not that it happens a lot. Whenever you're being kidnapped or, you know, silenced in an important meeting or a recording of something or something like that, whenever you're being silenced, what I like to do is not kiss, but extend my tongue and lick the palm of the... Now, I realised there's a potential risk for me as well, depending upon how hygienic these people are.
Yeah.
But you'd be surprised how many people pull away and how quickly, and you're the prick. I don't know. Well, I've got the kowtow, Cantonese kowtow, but that is like the way we've adopted it into English, the kowtow.
Mm.
It's a kneel and a low bow. That's very submissive. And unless they're agreeing to it as well, I suppose it's kind of like, yeah, you don't want to be rolling up, particularly if you're like going in to negotiate to buy a house or something. Hey, we're going to... Hey, this guy's on his knees. Push the price up. You know, it's one of those sort of things. Right, fist bumps. Like nice. Handshakes,
yeah.
I would ordinarily say they're kind of nice. Insofar as, again, teamwork, you've got to go in there.
Yeah.
But in my current status,
not good.
Not interested in fist bumping. But I mean, there's also the vagary of knowing whether they're going to go or whether they're going to go in for a. One of them,
or something
else, and you don't know. So you know, it's not like with the classic Top Gun, where you go in there and you give them a preamble. I feel the need to punch your fist. It doesn't happen.
Doesn't happen.
I've only got one, a couple more. Yeah, okay. a punch in the arm. You only do that if you haven't seen the person in a while, or if you slept with them and haven't seen them in a while. Oh, how you doing, champ? Oh, it's still making that scrolly noise.
I've still got that rash.
And that's, I think that's all. No, hang on. This one here. This is very, right, there's two here. That one was just the sillier side, which was, you know, Your Highness, which obviously... is potentially, it's a minefield of sincerity and sarcasm, and also the possibility that you're going to blow their ego up to the point where they actually start treating you like some sort of peon. So that's bad. Don't do that one. And the other one, this is very specific to me and my friends. And I thought, for a while, I wrestled with whether this was appropriate PC, good or bad or whatever. And it's this, right? It used to be, we'd be at the pub, some mates, and then my mate Greg would arrive and he'd go, "Hello. Is this the gay table?" Right, which on the one hand sounds a little bit like, ah. It's like, you know, walking into a room and going, "Oh, all right, gays, you know, whatever." But it's not, because he'd then join us. So he's gone straight from, it's sounding like it's derogatory, and then suddenly it's actually a, I'm in the right place.
Yeah, what he's doing there, he's playing with the ideas of the people who are watching, isn't he? Because what he's doing is he's walking in and he's going, "Is this a gay table?" And expecting everyone to go, ooh. And then when he sits down, they're like, I am
the knobhead in this situation. I didn't realise this was where their AGM took place. I imagine there'd be more. But yeah, I mean, like I say, there's no malice involved in it at all.
Yeah, yeah,
and,
no,
and
no,
what
no.
originally started lovely, out lovely, as lovely. A slightly sort of, oh no, I didn't deserve yeah. it. It's now just this sort of sweet thing that occasionally happens, and you know, and that's, so there we go. What's your fourth?
Right, I go drinking quite a bit recently, to be fair, with a couple of other poets, Steve and Emma. And I love them dearly.
Steve and Emma and who? Dave Pitt, Steve and Emma, and who's the third?
Yeah, very funny. And
Oxford commas, very
And, look, I have this thing. I'm trying to be less on time.
Okay.
You know, I'm always on, well, I'm this always really not, early for everything.
This is not a problem that has plagued me.
It's not, is it? No. But I'm trying not to be as much clock watching. Right. So I tend to turn up there, and partly because I walk to the pub, and I kind of deliberately try and misjudge how long it's going to take me. So I tend to be the last one that turns up. And then, as I walk through the door, they'll go, "Here he is."
Oh, that's nice.
And it's like, oh.
I like that.
And he was even better last night.
Oi, oi!
He was even better last night because I walked all the way to the pub. Walked into the pub. Walked all the way to the other end of the pub. Walked all the way at the pub. Got on my phone. Phoned Steve up. I went, "Steve, I'm in the wrong pub." And I'd walked a mile and a half... in the wrong direction because I forgot we were meeting in another pub and not
because there are two pubs called the Jolly Cobb
because there are two pubs which we meet in and I thought we were meeting it and we were, and so when I did eventually get there
they said "Here is," but it was in a slightly different tone. it was a slightly more not weary mocking
but there was a point waiting for me as well.
Was it flat?
No, they'd waited, they'd kind
oh,
of...
that's nice.
..knew roughly when I was going to turn up, and they'd just
was, point. Do you know...
But that, just walking into a pub and them going, "Here he is!
Here he is!"
And he's like...
That's how he liked that. I really like that. Pedestrian handshake just doesn't seem to cut it anymore. No, I was balancing the balance of power,
mm-hmm.
the familiarity, the ease of the actual greeting, mm-hmm. the likelihood for it to currently cause me pain, the confusion inherent, the fact that there may or may not be extra steps, all of this stuff.
Whereas what I was doing there was kind of, I mean, there's the hugging is just like, and what it is about that one in particular is, it's kind of a personal one, so it's not really applicable to others. It's also the fact that, you know what, at the end of the day, I don't feel like I belong with them because they're so much better than I am at doing poetry. And if Emma sees this, she's going to do a fucking nut because she hates it when I do this.
And yet, knowing full well it was going to be recorded and put onto the internet for forever to be discovered by the ant people in millennia once they figure out computers and then subsequently the internet.
But it is really nice to just two people you admire going, "Here he is," and being pleased to see you. It's great.
What is that like? What is that like?
Oh.
Two whole people in one place. Yeah.
Because you normally, you have to go to your mum's and then your sister's, don't you?
I do. Talking about Greek, I mean, I've...
What's your fourth?
I've been saying howdy quite a lot.
Oh, shut up.
I've been saying howdy.
Oh, behave. What's your fourth?
No, I've been saying howdy quite a lot.
What's your fourth?
I've been saying howdy.
Yeah.
In a sort of a... But and it's not... It's because I think it's that...
You think you're in happy days?
I've been trying to
be the fun.
I've been trying to adopt... I've been trying to adopt the sort of... That sort of Southern American charm of howdy, ma'am. Howdy, sir. You know, right. A real sort of sir, ma'am, sort of respectful. You know.
Where were you born?
Blockswich.
Okay.
So what?
So what?
You're wearing a not quite Jack Daniels, but you are relying on people knowing the Jack Daniels look.
Yeah.
And
but
you...
it's a, yeah, but it's not a Jack Daniels
it's
shirt.
Boston?
No.
That's America too.
It's proper Boston.
Well, there you go.
It's actually a Black Country t-shirt.
No, I know already. I did read it. It's one of my skills. It's one of my many skills. So, no, I'm just saying I don't... Although, I've realised that it's ever so slightly cowboy and a bit quirky, and now that I've identified it, I probably shall stop.
Right. My throat's going, so I'm going to have to cough really loud in a bit. So let's try and get through this.
Okay.
Bobby K.
Yes,
in summation, your fourth favourite greeting is...
The classic handshake.
Pause it.
I wasn't quick enough. Artie.
Oh, I've got that after that cough. You know, when you have them spots in your eyes.
Yeah. I think that's probably the preamble to a heart attack.
Great.
How's your arm feeling?
Right. Well, that's that then. That's how that worked.
For a generally pedestrian sounding question.
I quite enjoyed that.
A bit of fun there.
Yeah, yeah.
I think maybe. Hey, have we improved as? Let's call us performers.
No.
If
you enjoyed what you saw. Like and subscribe, leave a comment. If you got any questions for us, leave it in the comments. Do all that stuff. We're back whenever there's a 4 in the day. So this should be the 4th of April, I think. And then the next one will be the 14th of April.
And so on.
Yeah.
Until one and or both of us die.
Bye!